we are going to learn about reproduction in animals. So let us understand what is reproduction. The process of producing young ones of their own kind is called reproduction. As you can see in the pictures, a cat with kittens, a sheep with lambs, a cow with calf. All these animals, they are producing young ones of their own kind, and this process is called reproduction. And animals reproduce to continue their generation. All animals reproduce in two different ways. The first one is by giving birth. And the animals that give birth to young ones, they are called mammals. And the second way in which the animals reproduce is by laying eggs. The examples of animals that give birth to young ones, a bitch give birth to puppies, a whale give birth to calf,
and a mare give birth to colt.
And there are many others. And the second way in which animals reproduce is by laying eggs, like snake, hen, ostrich. All these animals, they lay eggs to reproduce. Now let us learn about both the ways one by one. The first one is animals that give birth to young ones. And we know that animals that give birth to young ones, they are called mammals. And few examples of mammals are cow, lion, panda, whale, dog, cat, elephant, tiger. And these animals produce milk to feed their young ones. And these animals have hair or fur on their bodies. The young ones are carried within the bodies of their mother. As you can see in the picture, the elephant is carrying the young one. And it is going to carry the young one's body till they are fully developed to be born. And mammals, they take good care of their young ones. They feed, they clean, and they keep them safe until they have learned to look after themselves. So tell me one thing, do you think that humans are mammal or not? The answer is yes. Humans are also mammals. Why? Because human female give birth to a baby. A bat is also a mammal, and the bat is the only mammal that can fly. A bat lives in old buildings or caves. It gives birth to young ones. The mother bat feeds the babies on its milk, and it also takes care of them. Even dolphins and whales, although they look like fish and they live in water, but they are not fish. Dolphin and whale are aquatic mammals. They give birth to young ones and they feed them on milk. As you can see in the picture, a whale is feeding its young one, and in this picture, a dolphin is feeding milk to its young one. So dolphin and whales are also mammals. Now let's learn about animals that lay eggs. Birds, fishes, reptiles, amphibians, insects, they all lay eggs. Some young ones that come out after hatching, they look like the parent animals, while some look very different from their parents. But as they grow, they look similar to their parents. Now we know that animals that reproduce by laying eggs are birds, fishes, reptiles, amphibians. Now we are going to learn about all of them one by one. The first one is birds. Birds lay eggs in their nests, and a nest keeps the eggs and the baby bird safe. Now let's understand the structure of an egg. The center of the egg is the yellow and it is called the yolk. The yolk contains the growing chick or the embryo. This is an embryo, and with time it grows to a chick, as you can see in the picture. So there is an embryo in the yolk. It is the growing chick. The yolk also contains the food for the growing chick. And this yolk is surrounded by a watery transparent material which is called albumen. A bird's egg has a hard shell to protect the chick growing inside. A mother keeps the eggs warm by sitting on them. This is called incubation. So incubation means to keep the eggs warm by sitting on them. And once the incubation completes, the eggs hatch and the chicks come out. Now let's see reproduction in fishes. A fish lays thousands of eggs together in water. This mass of eggs of fish is called spawn. So spawn means a mass of eggs. This is a spawn. Fish eggs do not have protective shells. They are covered with soft jelly-like material. Out of thousands of eggs, only a few hundreds develop into adult fishes. Why? Because most eggs and young fishes, they are eaten by the bigger fishes. Now let's learn about reptiles' reproduction. What are reptiles? Reptiles are the animals that crawls or moves on its belly or on their small legs. So all these are reptiles: snake, tortoise, lizard, crocodile. And these reptiles, they lay eggs on the ground. Their eggs are protected by shells which are thick and leathery. As a result, these eggs do not break when laid on the ground. And the eggs are not incubated by parent reptiles. That means that the parents don't sit on the eggs to give warmth. So how do they get warmth? They get the warmth for their development from the sun. Even after hatching of eggs, the parent reptiles, they do not take care of their babies, and because of which many eggs and young ones are eaten up by other animals. Now let's see reproduction in amphibians. We know that amphibians are the animals that live on land as well as in water. And frog is an amphibian. A frog also produces spawn of eggs, similar to the fishes. Spawn is the mass of eggs, and it lays eggs in safe place in water. The eggs of frogs are covered with jelly. The development of frog has many stages, which is called the life cycle of a frog. The eggs hatch into tadpoles, which look like little fishes. After a few days, tadpoles develop hind limbs and forelimbs. First of all, two legs are developed like this, and after a few days, all four legs are developed in tadpoles. Now, after a few days, they grow into young frogs having tails. Can you see the tail in this young frog? Now they look similar to their parents. In the next few days, the tail also disappears and an adult frog is formed. The adult frog lives on land and reproduces in water. Now let's see how insects reproduce. All insects develop from eggs. Some insects like grasshopper and cockroach, they have 3 stages in life cycle. Insects like housefly and butterfly have 4 stages in life cycle. The 3 stages in the life cycle of a cockroach are egg, nymph and adult. The nymph is the baby cockroach that hatches from the egg. It does not have wings. As it grows, the old skin is shed off and new one grows. This is called molting. So, molting means shedding off the old skin. A nymph becomes an adult cockroach after many moltings. The 4 stages in the life cycle of a butterfly are eggs, larva, pupa and adult. The young ones which hatches from the egg, as you can see, once the egg hatch, the young ones come out and it is quite different from the adult butterfly. It looks like a worm and it is called larva. The larva of the butterfly is known as caterpillar. It feeds on leaves and grows rapidly. After some time, it covers itself in cocoon. Now it is called pupa. So once the caterpillar covers itself with cocoon, it is called pupa. Finally, the cocoon bursts and the adult butterfly comes out. And insects also do not look after their babies. Now we know that fishes, reptiles and insects do not take care of their babies. Many of these young ones do not survive as they do not get proper protection. The young ones which survive help them in continuing their generation. Birds and mammals take care of their babies. Such animals have large number of surviving young ones. So in this chapter, we have learnt about reproduction in animals. All animals produce young ones of their own kind and this process is called reproduction. And there are 2 ways in which the animals reproduce: by laying eggs and by giving birth. The animals that give birth to young ones, they are called mammals. And amphibians, birds, fishes, insects, reptiles, they all lay eggs. While mammals, they give birth to young ones. And birds and mammals, they also take care of their babies, because of which they have large number of surviving young ones.